trying to convince us it's your story.
So, I grew up in Hungary, and I lived in a house on a hill. And I was in kindergarten around 5, I think. And I just got a new bike, and I thought I'm like totally can like handle this bike no problem. And I decided to go down that road that went up to her house, which was, since we just had construction, it was like gravel and stones. Lots of crying, sitting in the gravel.
Bike just enough so that I knew what I was doing and I was kind of beginning to show off. And went out with my friends one morning and we were having competitions going down the slope, lots of gravel, especially at the bottom. And sure enough, you know, I wanted to take my hands off as I got down towards the end and over the bars, gravel all in the forehead, and I ended up in the hospital.
Because she used personal pronouns, like she said she about the neighbors, and she was a bit precise about some details.
The neighbor detail is pretty convincing,
but I don't know. But sorry, she also gave a lot of details, so I don't know.
Gina gave a lot of details?
Yeah.
Okay, any other thoughts? Which way are you swinging?
I like the story of being true story, so that's too bad. It was creepy. I just like the there's nothing to do but like and
like
in the way they delivered it, or the language of their bodies, or the tempo, or it's all really pretty good.
So I was 5 years old, and as a 5-year-old, there was a bit of
sacks at the bottom of my head with blood just coming out. And I remember trying to, I was alone, so I was trying to, trying to find someone, and I couldn't, so I was, you know, crying home, and then my mom opened the door and just painfully cleaning all this stuff out of my head, and then just covering my head with bandages, so I had more bandages than pants.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, 5 years old, living in Toronto. We have a nice big house and a park just about 2 blocks down. I was allowed, even at that age, it was another time when it was easy, you could go out and be alone on the street. And I just was coming home from playing in the park and running along the block, a trip, and fell and face first like this. And my hands go into the sidewalk in the pebbles and the stones get in your hands, and I remember like crying like you wouldn't believe, and looking at my hands and thinking my hands are like completely ruined, crying like you, I was like running home, and my mom was there. I went through the door, my mom was shouting, "Mommy, mommy, mommy," and she had to wash it out, tell me like it's okay, your hands are okay. It's
I don't remember why I was outside. And I don't remember why I was running, but it's a sunny day and it's down my block, and I just trip and don't want to smash my face. My hands come out, obviously, it's like, you know, lizard reaction. And then I'm just like really nervous to look at my hands because I know it's going to be bad, and I turn them around, and there's blood, but there's gravel, which is horrifying because there are stones under my skin, and I've never seen that before, and I panic, and I like go home quickly but slowly because I'm in pain, and I open the door, and my mom, I scream for my mom, and she comes, and she cleans my hands, and it hurts, and I'm scared of the pebbles, and then she bandages them up, and that's all. Maybe someone will hire me as a strategist.
Yeah, Republican Party. Shall we vote? Oh. Well, I just don't know.
Just leave it a mystery till the
end. Should we the boy worried about wringing his hands, running home and getting them cleaned up by his mommy? Stand up.
Picked me up, drove me to the hospital. Country school took a long time. having to take the skin.
They did kind of a minor surgery and to fix everything and spend some time in the hospital. And
I like the way you picked up on the story because right away when he started, the first thing he did, he like folded his leg under himself. Almost like it seemed like a protective thing retroactively because you knew what you were going to say. And you were really showing like where the scar is and stuff like that. But then you did that too, which is pretty good. So one of you did a great job.
I was really feeling it. Like, I was like, if I was there, it was really like, oh, you are really feeling the pain of the nails, but it was also because it was the first one. But then, he picked up the word that you asked Jack about the flesh, so I thought, maybe it's you.
That's good.
Because you...
Great storytelling. I'm almost too good at storytelling. That's what I'm just too good. I can see it right now.
I'm proud. Either you're too good or you're
right. The saving grace could be it's good enough a story that you probably have told it to many people before, which means it needs growing. Like, it's enough of a cool injury that would make it a good story. So.
Yeah, I just. Was it Pixels, the detail about there being a hole and having to take a piece of flesh to fit that hole, didn't it?
No,
she said about the skin graft. You said it about something different. Which I also had.
Yes.
The skin graft. I don't know the strategy. I want to try and feel who's telling the truth. But when there's glaring, I'm definitely going to vote for Iniki.
The
real driving of the nail into my foot, as some idiot put it, and our trap is.
Just because